Hello everybody and welcome back. In this short video I want to explain you how to get from the causal action principle to causal variational principles. This construction is quite useful because it makes it possible to work with causal variational principles, which is somewhat more convenient. Okay, of course we again start with the causal fermion system. Let H F rho be a causal fermion system and rho a minimizing measure. And rho a minimizer of the causal action, of course, under the constraints. Okay, then we know from the previous video that the trace is constant on the support. So this means if we can denote the support by M, then we know that the trace of X is constant on M. This is all quite good because by restricting attention to operators of constant trace, one can satisfy the trace constraint, or one can leave out the trace constraint. Okay, in order to get to causal variational principles, one needs to do a few additional things. First of all, we treat the boundedness constraint with the Lagrange multiplier. Kappa, this means we consider the, instead of the causal Lagrangian, we consider the Lagrangian L kappa of xy, which is defined by, well, the causal Lagrangian plus kappa times the spectral rate of xy squared. Good, then also the boundedness constraint is taken care of. There's one more thing, namely in the setting of causal variational principles, one considers a manifold. So curly F should be a manifold, which according to our definition, it is not the case. However, one can make an extra assumption, namely that rho is regular. Well, what does this mean? Well, we already had regularity of space-time point. Well, in rho is regular is every space-time point is regular. Regular in the sense that X is regular for all X in M. Well, an X regular, this means, I mean, just as a recollection, so that, just to remind you of the definition, that X, the dimension of X of H, is equal to 2n, so thus the operator has the maximal possible rank 2n. Okay, it is not known whether every minimizing measure is regular. I guess it's not the case, but at least it is the case in most interesting examples. So therefore this is a sensible assumption, because in most examples this is in fact the case. Okay, and then it turns out that the regular points of curly F, they form a manifold. Let's just write it like this, and let's also fix the trace right from the beginning. If we introduce F reg, this is defined by all the points in F which are regular, and their trace should be the constant which we had above. Maybe I should call the constant here little c, and trace of x is equal to c. Maybe I put here an index c. Okay, so this is again a set of operators, so a subset of L of h, and it turns out that this is a manifold. Well, and if the Hilbert space is finite dimensional, then it's a finite dimensional manifold. So I should be here more precise. If the dimension of H is finite, in the finite dimensional setting, this manifold is finite dimensional. I mean, there we have an explicit formula for the dimension. It is a, well, a usual non-compact manifold. And if the dimension of H is infinite, well, then it is a Banach manifold, an infinite dimensional Banach manifold. Okay, I don't want to prove this here, but you find the details in two papers. I mean, in the finite dimensional case, I did this together with Sebastian Kindermann, who was a master student in my group. And our main research was that there's a connection to gauge fixing. In the infinite dimensional case, I worked this out together with Magdalena Lottner, who is a PhD student in my group. And you find the links to the papers on the website. I hope that the result can also be understood intuitively by saying, well, if the operator has maximal rank, and then, well, it can be perturbed smoothly. I mean, you change all the eigenvalues smoothly and all the eigenspaces smoothly, and this is why the resulting set of operators is a smooth manifold. Of course, the question is how to choose charts and how can you show that the transition functions are smooth and all of that. But this is something which is worked out in detail in these papers. Okay. Once we are here, so again, I mean, it doesn't work for any minimizing measure, at least it's not so clear. We restrict attention to minimizing measures which are regular in this sense. Well, but then we can say that rho is a minimizer, or at least say a critical point, of, well, and now I write down really a causal variational principle. Well, where the action is, the integral, again over, well, now we integrate over f rec c, d rho x, integral f rec c d rho y, well, and then here we write L kappa of x comma y, where we minimize now over all Borel measures on f rec c, and the only constraint is that the volume constraint must hold. So this means minimize over all regular Borel measures on f rec c under the volume constraint rho of f rec c is constant. Okay, so this is it. I mean, in this way we have kind of having a suitable, well, sufficiently large class of minimizers. One can also view them as critical points of a causal variational principle. And therefore, one can work with the Euler-Lagrange equations, which for causal variational principles, which I will derive in detail in the next video. Okay, good. I hope you found this instructive and see you again soon.